It's Comic Boom here to review Supergirl issue 25. This is an extra sized issue. It's $4.99. It contains three stories. It's actually a lot of bang here for your buck. Pretty decent stories here. Mark Andreyko continues his story that has been carrying on with Supergirl looking for the secrets of Rogel Zar and the secrets to who destroyed Krypton. And there's also another story here dealing with her newfound companion, Zinder Cole, who is an archaeologist, a space archaeologist, and has an adventure, a past adventure that he was in where he actually came across a dead Kryptonian colony and he acquired a Kryptonian artifact, which I suspect might provide some clues as to what Rogel Zar has done in the past. The dead Kryptonian colony likely being one that was destroyed by Rogel Zar. That's interesting. And there's also a nice kind of like a nice little, it's almost a Christmas tale, but it's by Dan Jurgens, who does a backup story here dealing with a, it reads like a Christmas story, although it may not be overtly Christmas, but it's it just has to do with, it's a cute story with Supergirl, Kara, looking for her doll that she had when she was a young girl on Krypton, and she ends up letting a young Earth girl keep it because it's something that it's a very touchy feely kind of comic, but story. But in any event, the main two stories here, two out of the three stories are more interesting to me. And basically, Zindel Cole is with Supergirl, and they're in Kryptonian space. They're in the spot where Krypton was destroyed, and Supergirl is looking for clues. Of course, they're surrounded by kryptonite radiation, and so Supergirl needs to be protected in her spacesuit. But she ends up confronting a new enemy, or what appears to be an enemy at this point, a character by the name of Splice, that seems to have multiple powers. This character, Splice, seems to have the powers of a Tamaranian, because she has energy blasts. She seems to have the powers, a shape-shifting power of a Durlan. And she also has another power here, which she's got the power of, she can withstand deep space exposure, so she might be a Dryadian. Now, I'm not familiar with Dryadian, a Dryadian race in the DC universe. If I'm familiar with that, I don't recall it. But in any event, I suspect that this character that she confronts called Splice is probably a clone and is probably a victim of another person's machinations by the name of Harry Holcomb, who ends up plucking Splice and Supergirl out together at the end and zapping them out of Kryptonian space, leaving Zindel Cole and Krypto, or his, I call him Krypto, but the dog's name is actually, a dog's name is P, LLC Pilsid? Pilkid? Pilsid? Anyways, stupid name for a dog. Apparently Pilsid is the name of one of Zindel Cole's family gods. It's not religious, but you never know, right? He says, I don't know, but anyways, dumb name for a dog. I don't know why they just don't have it. Why don't they just call the dog Krypto? Or why don't they just have Krypto around? But in any event, Zindel Cole and Supergirl run into this character, Splice, who attacks them because she's apparently protecting that area of Kryptonian space. And a big fight ensues, and Kara has hallucinations, and she hallucinates her father, Zor-El, building the very weapon that Rogel Zar was trying to use to destroy the Earth's core. And apparently, the origin of this weapon that was apparently built by her father Zor-El that Rogel Zar was using was apparently initially created by Zor-El in order to actually reignite a planet's core in order to save lives as opposed to taking them. So that's very interesting. So at some point in the past, it's at least implied, despite this being a hallucination, that Zor-El created the very weapon that Rogel Zar had used to perhaps destroy many of the planets over a long period of time. Now, that's interesting. We've learned more in this issue than we have so far in the pages of Superman dealing with Rogel Zar that actually stars Rogel Zar. But Rogel Zar is just sort of like a doomsday crazed maniac that's just killing and attacking everything over in the pages of Superman. At least here in Supergirl, we're getting some clues as to his past, even though it's in the form of a hallucination. because it's Supergirl, it might be something that she's remembering from her past when she was a young girl, because you got to remember that Kara did have a life on Krypton and came to Earth as a young girl, and so she has memories of talking to her parents, and this might be a repressed memory that she has. Who knows? It was a kryptonite-induced hallucination she was having. But it's very interesting reveal there. And in the backup feature, it does show Zindel Cole in one of his past adventures coming across in his role as an archaeologist. He comes across a dead Kryptonian colony and some past communications or some past preserved distress calls from this Kryptonian colony that was wiped out. And I'm guessing it was probably wiped out by Rogel Zar. So lots to chew on here, lots of fat to chew on. I like the fact that it's the art here is fantastic. It's gorgeous. There's multiple people in this issue that contribute to it. Andreiko, Jurgens, Lapicino, Walker, Derenek, Medina, McCarthy, Hennessy, Parsons, Plasencia, and Sotomayor all did a great job in this issue. And so I highly recommend it. It's one of the most substance-filled issues so far for Supergirl. And some really great backup tales. Dan Jurgens does a good job. It's a cutesy feel backup. And again, the backup feature with Zindel Cole is pretty good too. Check this comic book out. It's worth picking up. Guys, follow me on Twitter, Metropolis40. Merry Christmas. And until next time, comic boom.